Hello everybody, and welcome on this lectures on computer architecture. Today I want to take another look at the Carnot maps, because some interesting things can be said about these Carnot maps. Specifically today I want to talk about the exclusive OR operation and don't cares in the truth table. What to do with don't cares? That it doesn't matter in the truth table if it is a 0 or a 1. So let's take a look at what's going on here. Let me first go back to the lectures which we've done already until now. We have found out that the Huntington postulates that we used, they resulted then in these three basic gates, or actually these three basic operations, which we also call fundamental gates or fundamental operations, which are the NOT, AND, and OR gates or operations. So the gates have these symbols and the operations are, as you know, shown in the previous lecture. So actually we've then also said, by the sum of products and products of sums, that any logic can be implemented by these three gates. And then, for instance, we have the NAND, NOR, and exclusive OR. And I want today to specifically talk about the exclusive OR operation and gate, because it's a funny animal, so to say. Well, as you know, the truth table of all the possible 16 gates are presented here in this table. And the exclusive OR, let me see, where do we have it? A exclusive OR B is 0, 1, 1, 0. So let me put this in another way. Let me see where you have it here. So the exclusive OR has this truth table, that A exclusive OR B is 1 if A OR B is 1 but not both. So then we have learned how to do any logic by converting them to sum of products and products of sums. So let's first do this here, the sum of products, which I've already prepared here. Sum of products means that we're going to do an OR operation with a set of AND operations. And I've already written here, these are called the min terms, as you know. And then what do we have to do for the sum of products is actually copy all the min terms, all the products that have a 1 in front of them in the truth table. So that means we have this line and this line. So that means now I can write it down. A exclusive OR B actually is not A AND B, or A AND NOT B. So this is some kind of pattern you should recognize. A NOT B, or AND NOT A B, or A AND NOT B. So how to now put this in a Carnot map? Well, we already know how to do this. We divide here the table into two here, and we write A AND NOT A, and we write here on this side we can use B AND NOT B, and it doesn't matter so much where and how we place these variables. As long as you're consistent, you will get familiar with it. It doesn't matter how you do it, it will always result in the same way of the solution. So NOT A B, or A AND NOT B, NOT A AND B, that is then written here. There's a 1 here, and A AND NOT B has a 1 here, and all the others are 0. These are the other two zeros. So we get this kind of structure. And as you can see here, if I put here, if I write the A in black, sort of like this, and the zeros, the ones in black and the zeros I write white, you get some kind of chess pattern. And this is then the idea. If you see in your Carnot map, this is a Carnot map, if you see in a Carnot map you see some kind of checkered or chess pattern, then you know, wait a second, I think I can do this one with an exclusive OR operation or gates. Let me show you here another example. I will do like this. I will take three variables, and I will take here A NOT A, and here I will put B AND NOT B, and then here I will put C AND NOT C, and let me put here a checker chessboard pattern, or checker pattern, whatever you want, whatever your game preferential game is. And you see here, you have this, these are the black squares, and the other ones are the white squares. So actually, what do we have? Let me write it down. We have this one here is A, B, C. Then this one that we have here is an OR, A, not B, not C. And then OR, let's see, what are we going to do now? Not A, B, not C, that is this one. And we have OR, not A, not B, C. So I've written down these four AND operations for these four ones in the truth table. I didn't show here the truth table, but I only show here the Carnot map, but we see the checkered pattern, and then we go back to this equation. Equation, not an expression only. It doesn't equate to anything, it's just an expression. So let me put here in brackets then, we have B and C, OR not B and not C. And this one I will put not A outside parentheses, so we get B not C or not B C. Oh, that is nice, because now I recognize here B and C, B and not C or not B and C. I recognize this, what I told you before, I recognize this kind of structure. So what do we have here is not A, B, exclusive OR, C. And what do we have here? A, well, this one, as I've shown in a previous lecture on the Morgan's law, this one actually is then the inverse of B or not C, the inverse of B exclusive or C. So we get this structure. And now again, we recognize this pattern, not A, B or A, not B. We get not A exclusive or something and A exclusive or not exclusive or something. So what do we get here? Now I'm already missing space, so just let me write it here by your permission. This is then is equal to A exclusive or B exclusive or C. And the parentheses, actually, if we want, we can remove them. So let me put this now in red. So we see here a nice checkered pattern. Completely checkered pattern, chess pattern, and what do we get? We get completely made up of exclusive OR gates. So that is something interesting. You should remember chessboard pattern, and that is then we use exclusive OR gates. Now, something else I want to talk to you about this, about our Carnot maps, is that sometimes in the truth table, let me put it here in red, sometimes in the truth table we have sort of like don't cares. And to give you an example, if we make some circuit that uses binary coded decimal, binary coded decimal is that we use four binary bits to represent only numbers from 0 until 9. So 0 in binary is 0000, and 9 in binary is 1001, and all the others, these, it doesn't matter how the circuit works, because it will never reach there. It will only code binary coded decimal. So I only have to worry about these elements in the truth table. And the other ones, I will just write an X that I don't care. And then when I design my circuit, I will use whatever is convenient. So I've already prepared here this truth table into a Carnot map. Here we have the Carnot map with the projection. We're going to do a sum of products. So I've written it here, and once again, then this would be not A, not B, not C, not D. So this zero here wound up, it's this one. So now what we have to do, as you remember, with the sum of products, we have to look for ones. The largest number of pairs of ones, or quadruples of ones, or sets of 8 or 16 and so on, the more the merrier. So we have here, let me see, the easiest one where we don't care so much about the don't cares. So that would be these four. Yes, for instance, that's nice. So what does this red ones here represent? How do we do this? Well, I see that we eliminate the variable C, because it is here C and not C. And we can eliminate another variable, because we have two pairs of two. So which one are we eliminating? That would be, it has B and not B. So C and B we're going to eliminate. What is remains here? This is not A, D. these four ones are represented by not AD. And what we have to do, remember, we have to attribute at least one expression to every one in the Carnot map. So what else do we have here? We still have to represent this one and this one somehow. How do we do that? This one, well, we could just let it stand alone, but we can also join it with this one that is here. So that would already be two ones. That's nicer because the expression would be simpler. And I remind you, the one we can use several times. You can use a one as many times as we want, but it should be at least used once. But wait a second. So if that is true, then these two x's, if I take here these as one, then I can actually, and let me put another color like blue today, then I can actually join these four. And then this expression for this one becomes even simpler. Can I do this even more? No, I cannot make it into eight like this, and I cannot make it into eight because these zeros are necessarily zeros and I cannot include them into my expression. So actually I will decide to choose for these don't cares, I will decide to choose for them a one. And in that case, what do we get? We remove D from the expression. And what more do we remove? We remove A from the expression because these ones have A and not A. So what do we remain? These two blue ones are not B, C. And then what do we still remain to identify is this one that is here. We could let it alone, but let's see if we can join with more. Well, we could join it with this one, for instance. And then we can actually do more, because we can also join them with these two. As you can see, the difference, but they don't seem to be neighbors, but actually they are neighbors, because we have to think that this is like a cylindrical. So leaving on this side, we enter on that side. The difference between this element here and this element is indeed only one variable, namely the variable B, because this one has A, not D, not C, and this one has A, not D, not C. So the difference between these two is just this one has B and this one has not B. In this way, I can join these four together. So what do we have? B gets removed from the expression. What else is removed? C is removed from the expression. So we get this one is A and not D. So the final expression, let me go black to black, of this truth table, I just took any random truth table, would be A not D, or not A D, or not B C. And actually, as you can see, this could be used an exclusive or expression, as we have seen in the previous slide, I would say it. So this would be A exclusive or D or B and C. So we will have 1, 2, 3 gates in total. That's nice. We saved a lot of gates in this way. And the same thing we can actually do for the product of sums. So let me do this a little bit faster because by now you already get used to it. In the product for sum, we have to find zeros and attribute zero to at least one expression to every zero. So let me see what we can do. I see these two zeros. Well, can I join them with more? I could join with, no, not with these two because here's a one, but I could join them with these two here. So we get four. This eliminates actually two variables. Which variables? Well, I see here A and not A, so that one goes out. And I see here C and not C, so that goes out. So what do we have here? We have here not B or D. That is one, that is this one. And we still have to attribute this zero and this zero. This one is a little bit difficult, beast, because we can only join this one. Then let's see this one. We can only join with this one. And what do we get here? Which variable is eliminated? Well, that would be, let me see, we have here B and this is not B. So B goes out of the expression and this becomes A, Let's see here, A, C, D. The only thing that remains to be identify is this zero. How many can we join this zero? Well, we can actually take these four. We just take these four. We cannot do more, because then always we will add a one into them, and we could not do join with this, because that would make it six, and six is not exponent of two, a power of two. So we take these four, which variables are eliminated. I see here B and not B, so B goes out. I see here C and not C, so these are the two variables that are eliminated, and we get here not A, because both of them, all four of them have not A, and all four of them have not D. So that would be, I have to now, I'm in the product of sums, so that is this. So the final expression then would be, for the product of sums, would be, let me write it down, this A, not A or not D, and not B or D, and A or C or D. As you have already seen here, I should not have used here and, I should have used here an or operation. So this will be our final product of sums of this truth table, sorry, a little bit bigger, of this truth table. Here is this expression where we have filled out, I'm not going to tell you exactly how we did this, which zeros, which x's became zeros or ones, it doesn't even matter. What matters is that we have done attributed the first 10 lines of the truth table correctly, and this is what we have done. We have attributed all zeros, an expression to at least all to all zeros at least once, and we've taken the biggest set every time possible that includes that zero. So this is how we did this. Today we'll finish this, the Carnot maps. So what did we do? We talked about exclusive OR operation, and if you have an exclusive OR thing going on, then you see a chessboard kind of pattern in your Carnot map. And later, I've also talked to you about today about the don't cares, which are these ones that are normally indicated with an X. And the thing is that then you can choose a one or zero for these lines, for these values, whatever is more convenient. And I showed here in you an example how that is done. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. See you in the next one.